Sonic 3 is coming.
Look for the shadow!
On Groundhog Day. Make that Hedgehog Day.
Did you see the shadow? Look out!
Sonic 3, February 7th.
Hey, plumber boy, mustache man, your worst nightmare has arrived.
Pack up your stuff. I got a little surprise for you here.
Check it out. What do you think about that? We got real time, 3D, lush organic environments. How's that make you feel, buddy?
Feel a little like your days are numbered?
I'm going to have to ask you to leave.
You're hurting my elbow.
Is that Italian?
No, Bandicoot is an Australian name.
Beast you loved on Super NES. And now we've captured him on Game Boy in an all-new game with all-new enemies and worlds. Donkey Kong Land. New for Game Boy and Super Game Boy.
Yo, it's Sega's Toe Jam and Earl. The hip and the hop and the party that's kicking around the world. Giving it to you like it. Toe Jam and Earl is so funky, it'll make you scream
like nothing ever before.
Two homeboys can play a different gig every time. Go get your winner, you'll be in the hand. You gotta get it. It's a whole lot more.
Sure thing, Dad.
It's Bart versus the Space Mutants for your NES. Only Bart Simpson can save the Earth.
Bart!
Okay,
get the Simpsons game for your NES from Acclaim.
Bart!
Come on, Mario.
Come on, Mario, jump!
Want to grow? The calcium in milk helps bones grow.
Okie dokie.
You will believe an ass this fat can fit into a package this small.
I'm not fat. I'm getting in shape.
You better be. Because South Park is under attack.
Boomer, thanks for asking. Okay, you're going to jail.
Oh, I get to pop.
Hey, stupid, I'm over here.
Comedy Central South Park, now on PlayStation.
Howdy-ho.
From Acclaim.
Pounding out the hits. Super NES. Donkey Kong Country 2, Diddy's Kong Quest. It's even tougher than the original.
The Sega Genesis that comes with Sonic 1, you'll get Sonic 2 absolutely free. Sonic 2 handles stubborn stains, embarrassing bald spots, no problem. It even slices and dices, makes thousands of julienne fries. But wait, you can play it too. This free Sonic 2 is a $54.99 value. You get two Sonics for the price of one. Sonic 2 fits easily into any tackle box, made from a space-age polymer plastic for years of family fun, and pets love it too. Buy the Sega Genesis that comes with Sonic 1 and get Sonic 2 free.
Act now. Wiener dog sweaters sold separately.
And never be, no matter how they toss the dice, it'll be the only one for me is you.
Something's gone wrong in the happy-go-lucky world of Nintendo. Introducing Super Smash Brothers, where all your favorite characters go toe-to-toe in one four-player star-studded slam fest. Only on Nintendo 64. Two superheroes, Dashing Super Guy and Kirby from Nintendo. In some ways, Kirby lost big. No big hair, no big muscles, no weapons, nothing. All Kirby's got is appetite. Kirby's Dreamland, the thrilling adventure game on Game Boy. Kirby munches, spits back, and floats, saving glorious Dreamland. He's Kirby, and he packs a mean bite. The Kirby's Dreamland, only on Game Boy.
Hey, little buddy, want a ride?
Pikachu!
Yeah, whatever! I'll be right back!
Where can you catch all 150 Pokemon? On your Game Boy, that's where. Pokemon for Game Boy is here. With both packs, you can catch them all. Games and systems sold separately.
mother gave you the mumps. Your brother gave you the flu. Your best friend gave you chicken pox. It's playback time. With help from Dr. Mario, go head-to-head on NES or link up on Game Boy. Then contaminate, exterminate, and spread the viruses. When you score, you infect your opponent. Make him sweat, run a fever, get the chills. Dr. Mario, with two players, it's germ warfare.
Can I play?
Sure.
When is too much, too much? To find out, we crammed everything into Super Mario World 2, Yoshi's Island. 60 more levels, massive enemies, huge Yoshi tricks, all served up with the latest graphic technology, Morph Nation. Sure you don't have room for another little bonus level? Super Mario World 2, only on the Super NES. Still the big one.
Tony Hawk's Pro Skater. Now everyone thinks they can skate like Tony.
Video game review!
So, okay. Last week, Harley and I reviewed Ultra Enviro Man.
Whack to the curb.
It has got to go. So today, we're gonna take a look at Battletoads.
Rocket!
That it is. I mean, they got Psycho Pigs and Turbo Thwacking. And with kick fighting, surfing, babe shaving, how can you go wrong?
Your kid's a freak for Battletoads and these other games from Trade West, Nintendo Entertainment, or Game Boy Systems required.
Introducing GoldenEye 007. And the first Bond adventure. Where you direct the action.
Do you know how to use one of these?
Shot by shot by shot. Load a rumble pack and see how it feels when 007 meets Nintendo 64.
Bodacious experience with this speedrun game gear.
Remember old Bertie?
Wow! Check this atypical cover screen, man. Filthy graphics and a free game.
Oh, those were the days.
You can turn it into TV. Wow, excellent with headphones. Party on!
Grandpa.
Pop the hood. The hood.
It's Twisted Metal 4, and Sweet Tooth is large and in charge with all the high octane attitude you've come to know and love.
It's Game Boy Camera. It fits into any Game Boy. Just pick a friend, pick a nose, pick a friend's nose, eyes, ears, whatever. You can animate it. Then with a printer, you can print it out and stick it wherever you want. We call it
photography.
Game Boy Camera. Make fun of everyone.
Hey!
Picross, the mind-building puzzle game where clues and numbers uncover hidden pictures. It's as challenging as Tetris. Mario's Picross on Game Boy and Super Game Boy.
It's so big.
Unique exercise for your brain.
You can run, there's no escape. You can hide, that's his fate. He can fight with all his might and never win. When your battle's evil, the real game begins.
Talk to me!
This is Game Genie!
Frunkaloo!
The awesome video game enhancer for your
Nintendo Entertainment System.
Attach it to most of your video games.
Double Dragon 3 or
Super Mario Bros. 3.
You can go to any level.
Live forever.
Jump higher.
Make your own effects.
And get radical firepower.
Go to any level, jump higher, stay bigger, live forever. Game Genie, the radical video game enhancer.
Tetris, Dr. Mario.
Tetris, Dr. Mario.
Tetris,
Dr. Mario.
Stop! They're on one game back.
Tetris and Dr. Mario. It's twice as insane. Only for Super NES.
I'm gonna kick your tail.
No. I'm gonna kick your tail.
No, I'm gonna kick your tail.
Six great issues plus six free strategy guides on a hot new game. That's twice the power for still $15.
Wow, call now.
The people, and then now people can hear me. Welcome, all of my beautiful friends.
Hello, guys.
To another Thursday evening here with the Super RPG friends. We're having a good time. That's what we're doing. We're having a good time tonight, and we're happy you guys are here with us. But I'm really happy that I have an awesome lineup tonight. We got John, Joey, John, and Rachel. And I fucked up because there's two Johns now. Hold on.
Damn, Kelly.
Hold on. No. See, okay. So I fixed this earlier, and I think one of these is a reference, and the other one is a duplicate. That's what's going on here.
Joey's not even Joey. Joey's John.
Nope. Yeah, I'm John. Like, wait a minute.
Really
hold
close,
on,
man. It's not far off. I'll be John.
I guess I'll be John now.
There's just a lot of
Johns.
Five Johns.
I was gonna say an excess of John, but you can never have enough John, really.
An abundance of John.
Yeah, that's the name.
Six Johns, so it's a little excessive sometimes.
That's his fucking autobiography, an excessive.
Well, now you're
Johns.
Working with 11, bro, so deal with it.
John and with John.
You cranked up the Johns to 11.
Oh my god. But yes, this is episode 6 of Lunar. The last episode, we redefined the 100% speed run. For Lunar, which is a big thing that we did. We discovered something that the world record holder didn't know existed. Pretty proud of that. Pretty proud of that. Oh, hey!
Oh, whoa!
Thank you so much for the gift subs, Javi. Thank you so much, my man. It's great to see
you. Wow.
Woo! Oh my god, we gotta get some of them sub emotes in chat then from all you new subs, because they're beautiful. But yeah, so we did. Was Crystal Tower the episode before, or did we find out all of the horrible villainous things last episode?
That was the episode before.
Okay,
other episode we were going through caves.
Yeah, we went through a lot of fucking caves, and we talked to a lot of fucking people. Thank you, my man. I appreciate the hell out of you. So now we're on our way to fucking, what is it, Morbius's tower? We're going to go find Damon Jared Leto. Spire. No, Morbius's spire.
We're Morbin, guys. We're going to Morbin the whole fucking way.
Morbin
time.
There. But first, there is an extremely important item that we left in the town with the Thieves Guild. So we're going to have to grab that.
Frank's got to clean up his act.
Exactly. John, this is you're a great man, John. You're a great man, John. So before we switch on over, I'll just switch on over. For anyone who doesn't, John, Joey, do you have anything you guys want to mention beforehand? Other than that, we're gonna see about Kelly and Rachel, what they've done with Lunar in the past.
Yeah, I think just a quick
forward, I just so like full disclosure, Wes, Nick, and Monica won't be on the show in the future, unfortunately. Wish them the best. Hope you guys, the invite to always hop on is always here. So hope you guys have we're always going to be reading your articles and hanging out in any way that we can. So thank you guys for being part of the show for the time that you were. Big shout outs to Nick for starting it with me.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
So yeah, just in case, just so the viewers know, so they're not like, wait, what happened?
What happened?
Hip-hoppity happened. What?
But yeah, like moving forward, I think we're probably going to be having two guest spots for a while. So you're going to be seeing a lot of faces, a lot of familiar faces. Maybe if it doesn't cut into the coffers too much, we get a little Spencer action.
Oh, we've been hard at work. We got the new channel. We might finally have enough for the Spencer, which it was Spencer's birthday, like yesterday. So I just want to say happy birthday to my boy Ace Bonanza, if you somehow see this.
Oh, happy birthday.
Yes.
My birth.
So, in that, Kelly, I know we had you on for a Lunar before, but in case they didn't catch that, what's your experience with the Lunar series?
So I played Lunar Silver Star Complete when it came out, basically, when I was young and impressionable. And it's one of those games that I replayed a couple of times as a kid, and we had the little bonus disc that had like the characters playing Pong and
yes, I was going to say there's the cheat code that you did to unlock the little like four player Pong thing. Yes, so yes. Fucking cool.
It was incredible.
soundtrack disc.
Yeah, and since then I haven't really played it at all, and so coming back to y'all's playthrough has been, I don't know, just like a really nice sort of brush with nostalgia. Remembering a lot of stuff. Exactly.
Well then, yeah, so you're with me that whenever you see this like Sega CD stuff and just how completely different, I was talking to someone on the Premium Edition Games stream yesterday about the show, and they were like, oh, you know, it's cool to see what happens during a port. And I was like, this is not a port. It is different. Yeah, I was like,
actually, Frank, it is.
Actually, technically, if we're going to get extremely specific, it is one, Frank. If we're going to get extremely specific and extremely squishy.
Actually, it's Frank the Squishy port. It's actually, so what happened is that it was remade for the Sega Saturn, and then they upgraded the FMVs with the MPEG chip, and then that became the Lunar. That was the first time that the title Complete was used.
I didn't know that.
And then that got ported over.
Joey, no one redeemed the channel points for the Joey explanation.
I'm just over here like Joey's bitten the hard facts here. We're not even paying for it.
That's why we love him. Oh,
you'll pay for it, believe me. Someone will.
The last thing I'll add about my experience is I think I'm the only person on this chat, on this show, that prefers the Complete opening song to the Sega opening song.
It's a close one, man. I get it. They're both awesome. I do every Thursday at some point. I'm like, take heed!
So, I don't have that one memorized. I have the Complete one memorized.
Mm.
That's stuck in my head forever. It will never go away.
Alexa, turn the lights magenta. Provisor. Thank you.
And Rachel, what about you? Do you have, what's your Lunar expertise?
So I remember many, 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 many moons ago when I worked at Ye Old Stop of Games, I came across Lunar, the PSP version, in the bargain bin. And so I grabbed it and was like, oh, I think I've heard of this before. This looks very familiar. And I booted it up and I played it. I think I got like almost halfway through, stopped, never picked it up again until recently. And then of course, theme song's a bop. And when you guys started playing this version of it, of course, was the first time that I heard this version of the theme song, and I was like, oh my god, this slaps. So
it's got that 90s anime energy to it,
you know? Really does. It spoke to me like on a really personal level, I was like, oh man, I could listen to this in the car and like drive like 10 over the speed limit to this.
Fuck yeah. I think get a ticket listening to this music. Hell yeah.
I music should break Joey. Traffic
laws. Hey, too. What up, Riggs? How you doing, man? Thank you so much for stopping in. And yes, we do definitely need more 90s anime energy.
Oh, we'll bring it.
I was gonna say, Joey. Yeah, at that point, we might as well actually bring that. Let me get this bad boy started.
I'm redeeming this to tell you that the yes, Lunar uh-huh. PSP intro is the same musically, mm-hmm. at least instrumentally, as the PS1/complete version. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but they changed the fucking lyrics, man. I'm
it's garbage.
It's the same
cowards too. Absolute fucking so, cowards.
Rachel, if you get a chance after the stream, listen to the PS1 intro and be like, mm-hmm. "Ooh, that's so much better."
Yeah, I could wax lyrical about, like, you know, what's the word for it? Localization changes from console to console, and it's just bizarre why they make certain decisions with things.
Yeah, I think I think I may have mentioned this in what the show up, before, Solstice. But I'm pretty sure that PSP intro was changed so they wouldn't have to pay for the licensing on the original one. So just like changing one little thing made them like not have to worry about it.
I can see that. I can see that 100% happening just because of like the PSP is weird. Honestly, if you try to port anything onto a PSP or port anything from a PSP, there's weird rights things that go on.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Here we go again. A bop.
Every single time we do this.
We do, it's...
contractually required.
Yeah, it's essential.
It's so bright and colorful.
I'm just trying to Lunar pill Kelly, man. Or Sega CD pill, I don't know.
The Sega CD pill.
Fair. Fair.
I kept getting disappointed buying Solstice. Different versions and hoping it was a new game.
Well, I have a game for you, bro. It's called Dragon Song, alright?
Oh, yeah. No, actually, it's called Lunar Genesis. John knows this.
It is Lunar Genesis.
Oh, shit. Fuck. Are you guys ready? Take heed!
Oh, I forgot the slide whistle.
Oh, fuck! One of these days... You know what I love? I love the little... Hey! 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 Like the little like DJ scratch in between the haze. It's so good.
And you get what's his name, Mel, and then Tempest and some Kyle in there.
Mel out here like, you know, my daughter, she's a little susceptible to that multi-level marketing shit. Yeah. She's always she's bringing home Herbalife, all this other stuff, and she's like, Kyle. Now I will tell you that if you drink this shake twice a day, you will achieve a higher level of mental health as well as she's physical abilities.
Lulunar lemon.
There we go, guys.
Yes, Vice. Alright, random band we found while chilling at the bar. We want you to make a song for a sec. Like, they went to a fucking open bike night.
Yo, to be fair, the instrumental for, like, the guitar stuff was in the Japanese version, too. So, it's not as American as I thought.
Okay.
I was led astray. Yeah, I have so many fucking useless facts about these OP songs. I'm sorry.
It's okay, I love it.
Redeemed it. Nobody even redeemed the Joey.
No, Vicer had a queued up Joey explanation, and you just
read one.
You felt okay. It, you know?
I hate my life. I hate that that's who I am now. Oh, John, you're the man in the chair. Don't forget there, bro. You're the guide man in the chair.
Oh, I'm the guide man in the chair?
Yeah.
Oh, I just know I gotta go back to get a special item.
Yeah, a couple
of items. I can link you to the OnlyFans. That's all I can really do, man. I'm sorry.
The Patreon. Not Frank's, wait, but maybe? Oh my god, Frank's Southern Barbecue. No, my mom is from Jersey, baby. Like, there's a reason that the Jersey is so good, and it's because my family. Big woke and climate. I blame Big Lemonade for all my problems.
Big Lemonade.
Yeah, Big Lemonade.
Big Lemonade.
They're real fucked over there.
So, Rachel, as a fellow Floridian, I feel like you would appreciate Frank's, like, Christian Science mom voice that he does.
Oh my god.
Just you wait till we get, we'll get a good Jess voice going here, and you will hear. This woman does not know how to use an apostrophe if it fucking challenged her life.
I am ready for this.
Fantastic.
I've now mentally prepared myself for this moment.
Yeah, the only contractions that she has are like the seven that she gets for each of her children.
Of course.
Oh lord.
Floridians are all training for the apocalypse.
We're living in it. We're prepared.
Where do I hail from? I'm a southern reptile. I'm literally a lizard in human skin. Okay.
Hell yeah.
Reptilian Rachel. That's her Twitch name. Yeah.
Underneath this fleshy exterior lies a lizard woman.
Well, what do we got here? Mia's bromide. Oh, no! Hold on. What are you? Wait a minute. Wait. Hold on. What do we got here?
So this was in the
Nothing happened. Wait, what happens?
You have to equip it.
Oh, you have to equip it? Yes. And then what?
Don't you have to use it in battle or something?
I don't remember. Really?
What?
All right.
What? I'm not 100%.
We'll try.
Wait, Frank.
I couldn't figure out how to use it last time.
Did you see that dialogue with the green-haired person?
No, I didn't. 1 second. Oh my god, I bought tattered clothes. 1 second. I'm still getting used to the... Like, I just got confused and I was like, I'll take your shittiest clothes!
The shopkeep person up there by the...
Oh, the shopkeeper? Alright, 1 second.
Yeah.
The Guild of Thieves welcomed you to the bazaar! How may I assist you? Oh no, did he have good dialogue and I squandered it? Yeah, did he say?
He said something about selling. Could you go to sell?
Okay, hold on.
Oh, yeah.
Kid, you're still new at this, so I'll clue you in. This is the Thieves Bazaar. Thieves, get it? We don't buy stuff, we steal it! Hell yeah. That was 100% worth. Fuck yeah.
Wait.
I'm sorry, I'm just reading this comment here. Let me take a moment. Floridians will evolve to a point where we all sound like Pudding was gifted a voice.
It's true, bro.
It's true. We'll either be Pudding or we'll be lizards.
You ever go to a fucking Floridian golf course, man? It's all Pudding voices.
You're right. You are true. That's why I don't go to golf courses.
All right. Back to Marion.
We've got our soap.
Yes, we got our soap.
Clean up Frank's act.
Finally. All right, so then, Path to Daemon's Spire. We did all that. Myriad. It's a real... The fucking walkthrough, it says, Myriad is far north of Reza, so make your way north, and eventually you should be in Myriad. Myriad's a real hick town.
So people it's the there. Panhandle of Florida, is
yes.
what you're saying?
People there hit on girls left and right. Okay, yep.
No, it's L.A., Lower Alabama.
Oh, boy. That's true, too.
Wait, Kelly, do you remember the dialogue in this town, too, in the other version?
Okay, so now I see what I gotta do.
Wait, you broke up.
Oh. Yeah, I'm sorry. My internet sucks. Astound, man. 1-star ratings all around.
Oh, we know all about that internet in that home.
Like, this town is so funny. Like, the dialogue here is ridiculous.
We'll talk to some more people.
They're very hick.
Right.
All right, who wants this one?
Like, even though their inventors, Matt and Nick Taven, really different. Taven makes his inventions for evil uses, but Matt makes for man's good.
Good hood.
Sorry, I lost like 5 teeth saying.
I got this. They say that girls that sing real pretty are the ones Zenobia's targeting. I was hoping there was going to be a second. I was prepped for a second line of dialogue. I went full I'm on vacation at Disney right there. Oh here
village
we go.
On the other side of the river has villagers that have been... trapped by the evil inventor Taven.
Hey, even.
Honestly, like the break in, like the pause there is realistic.
It works.
I'm ready.
There aren't any pretty girls here, I should know. I'm related to most of them.
What the fuck? We're definitely in North Florida. This is definitely a Northern Juggalo place.
Northern Juggalo?
Yeah. Hey there! If I go on a quest, will girls like me too? We gotta get the next one. Yeah, I was gonna say, me, Rachel, and John, this is straight Florida town, so.
Yeah, no one else should have to speak, just you three here.
Less and less travelers are coming here these days.
Oh no, it's you guys!
I think.
Oh my god, John.
These days, I'm a mite bit discouraged.
I love how John's just meat wad.
You see, I've been living here to study this clan that started Marriott. It's part of my anthropology studies.
He's the smartest one in town.
He really is.
But now that the land is literally crawling with monsters...
Fucking holy shit, Six.
I can't get away from a town to take a break. I'm going positively bonkers.
Like,
I like how John had some little bit of whistle in there.
Yeah, just a little.
Like that,
a little.
Shh.
A little bit of there.
Oh my god.
Anyone can have this.
To tell you the truth, I don't put no bane on the hook there.
I was like, man, this sure is. Look at this author taking liberties, saying this is a hick town. All right, no, not at all. All right,
not at all, man.
Nail on the fucking head on that one.
Holy shit, Pfizer! He's trapped in this place. Typical Floridian. I honestly feel like that is a typical transplant. Floridian.
That's a Floridian transplant, just like me.
Oh, that's why John can't go full Florida.
Oh my god, Joey,
that
this is you, baby.
That dancer thinks she's good at what she does. Man, is she stupid.
That dancer is easy on the eyes, but she can't sing or dance worth veins.
Oh, yeah, actually. If you need a bird on command, I got you.
Not black beans, not kidney beans, none of them. Not Tesla beans. Damon lets monsters roam his spire in order to keep intruders out. If you're not good at fighting, you better stay away, believe me.
Just hand it to me.
Oh. Here we go. Let me prep my...
Yeah, you are the belle of this hick town right now. But you can't sing or dance worth beans, remember that.
You know, I've heard that girls sing real good. I'm being kidnapped. I wonder why I'm still here. Wanna hear me sing?
Oh, there's some Blanche Devereaux in there, man.
I was hearing the Blanche.
Okay, listen up. This song's gonna blow you away.
Oh my god. Joey backseated John's Florida prowess.
I'm not gonna say I didn't.
Yo, this should have been the opening song.
Yeah, honestly though, put the fighting in the darkness. Fighting Yay! Through the darkness.
Wow.
Oh, look at this. My ears are bleeding. I'm deaf.
Yes.
Okay, no, there's the that's the other half of the meat wad.
That's the other half of the meat wad.
I've hired a dancer like other bars.
But I don't make too much all at once.
No more. I wonder where that is.
God.
He's a drunk bartender. I don't know.
It's perfect. Don't worry. All right. I think I might have talked to the man to the left.
Yeah, we talked.
Oh, we already talked to him.
Last,
okay.
Last episode.
Yeah. If you happen to make it to Damon's study room at the top of his spire, please give him my deepest thanks for the education he gave me.
Education.
Edumacation.
That approves of Rachel's Northern Juggalo voice. Well, guess what? You want to hear a secret? I'm from the Panhandle originally.
Oh, got the ass.
Alright, so we gotta warp to Reza and then head southwest.
Hey, before you do that, Frank, can you go to the shop?
Absolutely.
Yeah, we didn't talk to everybody, so... The dialogue in this town is wild because it changes.
And the carpenter said he'd fix the bridge for y'all. That's mighty civil of him. But you know, he's a little, well off. Know what I mean?
You know what I mean?
Oh, thank you for coming to my humble store. How can I help you? Here, I think that if you sell your speed ring...
Fucking Jesus Christ.
You got something special.
That's it.
Him.
The diamond's ring. I sold it. It's gone. All right. The person's like, that's not a speed ring. And I'm like, shut the fuck up. Oh my God. I gotta watch out for it from all fucking angles now. Joey, you need to go in the other room and give your woman a kiss right now. That is worth it. Holy shit.
Dude, the thing is, though, is that she had a perfect setup earlier and fumbled it.
Are you backseating her fucking speed ring?
He couldn't get into the cell screen. I saw it happen. I'm like, I know where this is going.
That's so good.
Oh, that's what you were fucking doing. I'm like, yeah, I guess it's funny that you can't sell to thieves. Like,
I thought that I was trying to get you to sell the speed ring, but it fucked up. It wouldn't let me trick you. Backfired.
God damn it, it wouldn't let me trick you.
Oh, best laid plans, you know.
Chad all of a sudden. Chad wouldn't let you trick him.
Chaz came back.
Chaz was doing it.
Why is Hick being flagged?
Is it?
I don't know why.
No, we can definitely say Hick. We welcome the term Hick here.
Probably
in Super
the bullying again.
Yeah. The majority Florida rules that you can say Hick in this chat.
Yeah, we are the majority of Florida.
We made it, finally.
Yeah, if you think about it, three people in one Discord call are most of Florida.
Yeah,
I would say.
It's true.
We at least have most of Florida's teeth.
Yes, that is true.
Yeah, good.
Florida's teeth.
Wow, you guys are fucking abusing this power. Hey, Visor's got tagged too, so if I allow one, it doesn't just automatically...
Hicks can't. So, Visor said Hicks can't read, so they won't be offended. No worries.
Nash has one of the biggest zingers in the entire game in that town, and I'm trying to find a screenshot of it.
Oh, good.
Give me a minute. I took screenshots of all the text in Marriott in every single version, and they're all golden.
I appreciate you, Joey, just for shit like that. Like,
wow.
just committing right. too hard to the bit. But this... Okay, so I know I sent them to Kelly, so I'm gonna have to scroll through, like, 500 duck videos.
Maybe Nash wrote the guide you're reading.
Okay. What's that? Jesus, Alex! That isn't an island. It's a huge sea turtle.
And now we're crossing into Discworld.
Oh, hell yeah.
Yeah, yes. That's true.
Panhandle Juggalos call yogurt milk pudding.
Wait,
that is,
what?
That is factually incorrect.
Milk pudding.
I think you're just trying to appropriate Panhandle Juggalo culture, Six. I don't
appreciate it.
Also, I think the actual percentage of Juggalos that exist in the Panhandle is, like, now less than 50%.
They've migrated.
Of the population?
Yeah.
They're endangered.
Yeah. They're endangered.
They're an endangered species.
Endangered Juggalos.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Who'd have thought?
We always thought that the gamers were the oppressed minority, but it's really Juggalos.
It turns out.
We all peaked in high school.
I still, one day, I do want to go to, like, the Gathering of the Juggalos and treat it like a research, like, outing. Like, take notes and shit, interview some people. Like, how much methamphetamines do you have shoved up your ass right now, sir? Please.
A reasonable amount. A normal amount.
Yeah, just about as much as you'd expect.
Average. It's a legal amount.
Legal
amount, yeah.
Damn, it took me that long to get into a fight. I was like, I guess there's no fights out here.
Yeah,
I was almost impressed by how long it
took. All that is means that I'm going to fucking pay for that later today.
Right.
So.
Yeah, for real.
The first floor is going to get you.
I thought you just learned the, like, the tricks from the Done Zone last
Bro,
time.
Bro, he had them. He had the tricks. It was awesome.
Six, I will agree with your statement there. I know only like probably two Chuggalos at this point. Both of them are tattoo artists, and they are literally the sweetest humans ever.
Yeah, I'm friends with a lot of Chuggalos. They're pretty decent people generally once they get older.
Once they get older, but like early on they fucking
like
suck.
You know, high school Chuggalos, you know.
Yeah.
Like you have nice to age thread. Into Juggalohood.
Yeah, you have to age into it. You go too hard at the beginning. One. Yeah.
I don't think I've ever met one knowingly.
Well, that you live in Florida, you've met one without knowing it for sure.
Yeah. They're among all of us. So this dungeon is super complex in the other versions. This is kind of just
look at this motherfucker. He's just like, hey, bro, you seen the latest episode of Lost?
How about, have you seen my neck?
You, bro.
He's like, bro, I just finished Better Call Saul. You guys want to talk about it?
Bro, how many proteins do you consume? How many proteins?
Proteins? How much proteins?
Six eggs. That's the answer.
That's my favorite brand of eggs. Six eggs.
Six and two-thirds eggs. Six sold his eggs.
Oh my god, Kyle taking damage.
Yeah, these enemies...
yeah, it looks like those guys don't take physical damage very much. I'm about to test exactly how much, but...
There's a lot of enemies who are like, really weak to magic or really weak to physical here, and you end up using a lot of...
It looks like I'll definitely at least want to make sure Mia opens up with the icicle thing. Because that seems to take them down where I can still at least take... I got a Dover Nut! That at least takes them down to where I can hit them a couple times and they'll be done. You know what? I've constantly lived in fear. Is this my inventory limit? I have never reached it. It is? Oh my god, that's terrifying.
But you have a lot of, like, antidotes and shit you don't need.
I do. That is true. I'm trying to find my dang Dover Nut.
But the age-old RPG question is... What if he does need them?
Yeah, right, exactly. Yeah.
He can move some of them into the inventory of each character.
Yeah.
Oh, that's true.
There's a huge need for expired antidotes and, like, rotten potions.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I have to get a key to go up or something, don't I? Is that what it looks like?
Yeah, you gotta go down
to go
up.
Yeah, there's a whole... Okay, I see what's going on here. Oh, and we got
a map in front of you.
Oh, I do, baby. Oh, I do.
He's come prepared.
I've been doing this show too long to not do that.
God, this
bro, I got stuck. I was doing Rack and Ruin on last night's Premium Edition stream, and I was at, like, you remember the fucking the color dungeon for Link's Awakening DX, how you would rearrange how the rooms were? There is a dungeon like that, dude. It stumped me. I was like brute force, cuz like it's hard on stream too to be like, I'm going to like sit and like think like a fucking like anime protagonist about it. You know, you just kind of you got to do it. And I just, oh my god, it was so rough. But it's been a while since like a Zelda dungeon has had me like that, where I was like, oh my god.
Did you guys play the Link's Awakening remake?
I did.
Think so.
Yeah, I remember Kelly burned through that really
That's
fast.
One of my favorite 2D ones. I really love that.
It was so short. I was sad.
Wait, Rachel, do you like Link's Awakening? Or have you played it before?
I mean, I've played it before, yeah. But I just didn't play the new one for whatever reason. My time that I have to play games is very short, so I'm very picky with the games that I play now.
I feel
just because
that.
It's like, it's time management's a thing. Even though I get home a lot earlier than I used to with the new job, but my to-do list is endless. And my to-be... gamed.
It's also endless.
Yeah, it's wild. But
I started Xenosaga last night, and I'm like, do I have time for this? Like, and by time for this, I mean, do I have time to devote to this before I get bored of it? And
well, you have till about the second game, so.
I mean,
yeah, the second game is rough, but however, I'm playing them on an emulator, and there's a 4K textures pack for those games. And it, like, it looks so good. It looks better than Switch games. Wow. And
low bar.
Also, fast forward. Yeah, low bar, but fast forward in Xenosaga is like.
Okay, dude, I see what I got.
Necessary.
Do. Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
Especially, too. Holy fuck, dude. Like, I don't know how I had the patience for that.
Those battles, man. Like, it is rough city. Like, them good, like, 20, 30 minute long battles are just like, what the fuck? This is a random encounter.
Yep. And, like, I think what I used to do, one of the reasons why I listened to so much music back in the day is because I would turn on the music on my TV and then just, like, listen to an album. And I would just do that while playing. And I don't really do that as much anymore unless I'm grinding or something.
Yeah.
So, I think that's the move. That's the move to grind two things at once.
Yeah. Speaking of getting, like, bored with, like, games, that's why I have to play, like, multiple games at once. Like, I'll play one day, one the other day, one the next day. Because otherwise I'll just be, like, zooming through and I'll, like, miss stuff and stuff like that.
Oh, thank you, Six.
With the voice to text, Joey is a legendary amongst the NeoGaf chat plebeians.
Cake Six, dude. Thank you for this.
What a title. What an honor, really.
Yeah, because I'm over here playing all three Xenoblades at the same time.
Bro, what?
Yeah.
Wow.
Sounds like a fun way to do it, actually.
She's looking for those concurrent events, baby.
Yeah,
you know, I'm.
I'm at the, like, tail end of the first one. Like, I'm pretty close to the end. And I'm right before, you know, the kind of the big, one of the big reveal parts of the game, not to, like, spoil anybody in the chat.
Are you saying a long RPG has big reveals? No.
Oh, yeah.
No. It couldn't.
Well, it's it's like, you know, I just got to the city that I want to call them Featherfolk, but that's not what they are.
Hyantia?
Yeah, Hyantia.
Oh,
yeah.
Honey, you are not anywhere near the game.
Well, it's, you know, it's like, it's
oh, no.
You're over the hill. You're over the hill. Like,
that's at least 50% mark.
Yeah,
that's where I quit the first time I played it.
That's where I also quit the first time I played
Same,
it.
Same, actually. That's awesome. Yeah.
Because
wow.
That sequence just seems that when you get there, it just seems like so long because there's so many different things to do in that area. But
and the Aerith Sea is right there, and there's all this like stuff that you can't walk over and unlock, and it's just like empty map, and you're like, there's no way. You have to
figure out what like island combination to go through to like get to where you need to go, and of course the like map guide thing that shows you the direction you should be going, it gives you no help whatsoever. But I restarted Xenoblade 2 because I had no idea what I was doing, where I was, or anything, and I had forgotten like 60% of everything that I had played. So I was like, okay, we'll restart this. Maybe I'll get some better blades. And then I played like the first like hour or two of the third game, and I was like, oh wow, this is like got all the good things
so much
from
better, yeah.
Yeah, it has all the best things from both like the first game and the second game combined into one, into this, you know, not perfect but close to it iteration. And I was like, okay, cool, I can get on with this. But then I was just like, one of my friends like, you can't play past this chapter unless you finish this and this. I mean, it'll make sense, you could play it on its own, but you're gonna appreciate it more if you finish the other ones. And I was like,
yeah, that's
yeah,
pretty,
okay,
yeah.
All right. So I mean, I have time. There's not really any other thing that I'm like really into playing right now. The thing that I really am going to be into playing doesn't come out till February, so
it's the Lunar Dragon Song remaster.
Yes,
yeah, that's what it is.
Can't wait for that one. holy smokes!
Well, fuck off. Fuck off, Frank.
You're welcome.
Oh, I remember getting so fucking lost here. Actually, this dungeon sucks.
No, I'm very happy that I had a fucking guide to look at it and be like, wait a minute, how does this shit work?
I can see myself not realizing you can cross those little...
That you have... Yup, 100% fucking percent, dude. Oh my god.
I would have immediately been stressed out the moment I like walked down those stairs into this part of the dungeon. I would have been like, the hell am I doing? Where am I? When am I?
It's a one map maze. One map maze.
Say that.
I like how. I like how it. Well, shit.
I was hoping.
I like how it's got a little bit of loading on this stairway. Like the up and the down of this floor is different. Like there's a different map stored or something.
Yeah. I noticed that too. I was like, why is it lagging like that when he goes up the stairs?
Yeah, that's really observant, John. I'm going to try to pay attention to that next time he goes up the stairs now. Whoop.
Oh, wait, never mind.
Oh. Yeah, well, that's a shitty time.
The game really said, oh, Joey wants to observe this? Do not.
Yeah.
See, there was a blink.
Yeah. So that's definitely two different maps.
Okay, see, I just thought it was going crazy, so there you go.
I thought I was insane!
Yeah, that's a... Wow.
Oh, hydrate. Good thing I'm remembering to do that.
I need to fill my drink up, so I'll get the next hydrate. I am focused right now.
Yeah. That's an important gamer.
I'm in a true gamer moment at the moment. Gamer veto. Fuck off, Joey. Whoa, hold on, guys. I'm fucking vetoing that one. It's too hardcore out here.
Fucking veto. I took a screenshot of you, and it's one of the best photos I think
of me?
I've seen of you, Frank.
Oh, good.
Yeah. You're giving the stream the gamer eyes.
Good.
You know what? I think I can post it in here.
The gamer eyeballs.
Oh yeah, the focus, the map focus.
Can we? That's got it. Save that. We will absolutely make that an emote. That's amazing.
I posted it in the Discord.
I like that you can see the map in the reflection on the glasses.
Yeah. That's why I did it.
Oh my god! I didn't even.
You gaze into.
That's amazing. That's so good.
He only has eyes for Lunar.
That's all. Literally, that's it. Oh my god, I love that. No. Six is loving it. A toast to those who thought they always knew the absolute very best. Thank you very little, and you're welcome.
Even less.
That'll show them legendary NeoGAF punks what for.
Dude, I never posted on NeoGAF, man. I mean,
not
I
once in my
on
life.
Worst site.
Oh,
I posted
god.
On GameFAQs, baby.
Thought we were about to get Joey's 4chan arc there.
Oh, dude, never. No. I've been degenerate in my time, but never that level of degenerate. I think the closest to degenerate I've ever been as I kind of was like a memer on the WoW forums.
I was a little bit of a memer, you know, you can say. I did a little trolling, a little memeing, you know. You can't fault a man for doing a little bit of that. No, you can't.
Well, what I would do is I would talk shit to the Alliance people and be like.
As you should.
And then I would duel people and like the friendships forged through competitive dueling. Wow, I swear.
The friendships forged by me being a level 29 twink hunter in Battlegrounds. I think I still put some bad memories in people. There's some people who still see hunters and they go, ah!
Yeah. Dude, you literally, like, a serpent shot just kills you.
Oh, I love it because there's such a certain speck of people where I say, twinked out 29 hunter in vanilla, and they're just like,
you're talking about something way different.
No, God, no.
Twinked out and vanilla, huh? I don't think
I don't know about fuck off, Joey. Oh my god.
Actually, hold on. I have a really good question that I was thinking of right before the stream because I'm very smart. I have a smart brain and my brain is big.
Big brain.
Not really.
Big brain.
Really into Rick and Morty.
Yeah. So it takes a high IQ to understand Lunar.
To even get it. Yeah.
CD. I mean, you guys might not get it, so that's why we have the Joey explanation redemption, because of that. But but for real, like, so there are a lot of dead RPG series, or like dormant, or you know, comatose, whatever adjective you want to describe. Okay, I think there's a secret chest on this floor somewhere.
No, really?
It's like, I think it might be behind one of these.
One of these? We're going to find out, and I'm going to message Doan and go, did you know?
I swear this is not an elaborate speed ring setup. I'm like, genuinely. But okay, yeah, so here's the question. A lot of dead RPG series are dormant. Like, you know, you got Lunar, Breath of Fire, Grandia, a million, right? So
I'm surprised you didn't mention a particular one, Joey.
Wait, which one did I forget?
Golden Sun.
Oh, Golden. Oh, dude, of course. But like, okay, so a series that's been like effectively dead for a long time until recently is Valkyrie Profile, right?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. But what they did was that they released that mobile game Anamnesis or something. I think it's called.
Yeah.
So like, you're and actually.
Nope.
The Mana series too kind of did this. You have the mobile game, but you haven't. We haven't had like a new Mana entry since the DS game, Heroes, I believe, or Children. I forgot which one is first. I think it's Children that I'm thinking of. But regardless, so what you're seeing lately is a lot of RPG series that are like kind of on life support getting a mobile or gacha game.
Port of something.
Yeah. Something like that to try to like whatever. I'm wondering if this is becoming like almost a way to invigorate interest. And I think a really good example of this is Romancing Saga Universe, right?
Yeah.
Like, I know a lot of people who play that game who would never touch Saga proper. And or people who haven't played Saga since like they were a kid and like picked that game up on gacha. And or the gacha version of it. And it's a pretty good game for being a gacha for sure. So, I'm wondering for you guys, like, if there was, like, would you be okay or settle for something like, hey, there's not going to be a Lunar 3, but we've announced Lunar, like, the
gacha
silver,
game?
Yeah, Louvre, the Silver Galaxy gacha game, and it's like a, what do you call it, like a... like, it integrates all the Lunar, or the two... Well, no, three Lunar games, and then, like, you know, you pull characters, the battle system is like this, that kind of stuff.
Do you think there's enough content to pull from for that? I feel like the other games have more characters and stuff that would fill in.
Yeah, I'm not sure if it would translate well, if that makes sense, to, like, a mobile.
I can see it. Like, instead of the gacha style that Joey's talking about, it's just Candy Crush with like the characters' faces.
There you go.
There we are. We've unlocked the secret.
And you Candy Crush bromides, like you unlock them.
Yeah. Oh no! I think I hear Frank laughing. By the way.
Yeah, you do.
Okay.
There we go.
Yeah, no, I think honestly, I'd be more into the idea of Candy Crush Lunar than I would be a Lunar gacha. But
wait, you don't want S rank musician Alex, double S dragon master Alex. Yeah, you have Harp Alex and you have Ocarina Alex. See, they're different. You know, they have different banners. Then you got Summer Dragon Master Alex skins, which is very important. Yeah, she definitely showing straight shaft. Like,
I was thinking we'd be on a beach episode, but no, you went straight hot springs.
Oh, absolutely. Listen, I bought
hot springs. Hopefully we'll get to that point in this.
Please,
in this
I hope. Mm-hmm. I bought two fucking things of soap for some reason. I mean, damn.
We're about to get clean in this house. But, yeah, I mean, I don't know. I almost think that that's like kind of the trajectory for a lot of these dormant RPGs rather than just kind of, you know, rebooting them or adding another thing or whatever. Like, okay, I think Valkyrie Profile is another good example of this too, because it's like, would Valkyrie Elysium have been greenlit if Anamnesis didn't, like, wait, is it called Anamnesis?
Something like that.
Anatomia. Anamnesis is the Star Ocean one.
The Star Ocean one, yeah. I was like, wait a minute, I think that one's that one. I didn't think they had a crossover, so.
It just hit me now.
Yeah.
But Star Ocean Anamnesis is actually another good example, too, although Star Ocean is a little bit more relevant because that game came out, like, not long ago.
Yeah, there's another new game, Star Ocean game, coming out, too. Soon.
Yeah,
like in the next like month or so.
With the strangest looking main character I've ever seen in my life.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. Some of the ones in the one that came out, some of the characters in the previous game that came out before this one were a little
I've finally gotten to the point where, like, I accept that half of that series is not great. So, like, I'm at the point where now I can't just be like, well, Star Ocean, bro, it's going to be awesome. I have to be like, we'll see. Like, two may be one of my favorites, and I'm entirely tolerant of three and one, but, like, we're at that point.
Listen, First Departure, like, First Departure slapped. Love that one. And then Second Chapter, I was like, okay, and there's some really funny bits in it, but some of the parts, like, threw me off. And, of course, no one ever played Blue Sphere. I love Star Ocean. And then,
I booted it up.
Yeah.
At least you did.
I played it for, like, I want to say, like, 10 minutes, because I have, like, an emulated version of it, because I never got to play it originally, because, you know, it didn't come out here.
Yeah.
And I remember booting it up. I played it for, like, 15 minutes, and I was like, what is happening? What is going on? And then I just couldn't get around the art style. Like, I couldn't get over it. It was just weird. So
yeah, I watched the intro and I played, like, the first couple battles, and I was like, oh, this is kind of cool, I'll come back to it later, and just never did.
Yeah.
Johnny boy.
I was waiting for a pause.
No, you're all good.
Sorry, John.
But I think the series found my infinite. Why don't you try it?
Use Damon's key. Oh, there he is.
Yeah, that was quick.
Oh, wait, read the books, Frank.
Read the books?
You gotta read the books, yeah.
Oh, wait, I need to go I need to go to volume one. I can't see this out of order, I mean. Yeah. Oh, no, fuck! No. All right, we're just going with it. Volume 15, Common Sense. Video games will eventually rot the minds of all that they enslave. At least, that's what they're saying now. Who wants volume four?
I'll read Common Sense, because if you put your hand in the fire, you'll get burned.
Very good. Who wants Wisdom?
I'll do Wisdom. Volume 10, Wisdom. If you trust your friends, the way to the frontier will open.
Beautiful. Ooh, Errata. Okay.
Errata.
I can do that one.
Okay.
In a shimmering fountain.
Oh no.
The lovely maidens play like dazzling young fish.
You know, that's my number one compliment back in the day when I was out being a dog. I was like, "What's up, baby? You look like a lovely maiden playing in the like dazzling young fish."
I don't have enough fedora for that, Frank.
Yeah, not nearly enough. It hurts. I feel
like that may have made, like, the two people who lurked this Twitch extremely horny.
Probably. They've been like, I've been waiting for this.
Lineage. I, Damon, keeper of our collected knowledge, have no heir to leave it to.
You say that incel. All
right, then.
Definitely an incel.
Volume 7, power. The power of the lost dragons is the power of justice. Shut up, cop. It can be found in tiny things.
I heard someone doing, like, scream metal version of, like, something someone else said, and the whole time I'm just like, I don't like Ren on TikTok anymore, like. Volume 3, Prophecy. One will rise that has a power that will surpass all who have gone before.
You don't say.
Volume 1, Prophecy.
Okay, these are way different in
the world will
version.
Be pressed between light and dark. Many will suffer. But a girl's love, and a boy's shout, will determine it all. Thank you, guys. This is why we all collectively get along. This guy's like, ah, hello, you've climbed my tower. Oh, why are you going in the chest behind me? What the fuck?
Just getting that vigor peach.
All right.
Chests are fair game to the hero. Come on now.
Speaking of, like, horny things, Vigor Peach, man.
Now, guys, remember, he does not have an heir to leave his... Whoever takes this voice, just remember that. He's got no heir. He's got no bitches.
No heir.
Kelly?
Why do I get the no bitches voice?
You clearly have no bitches.
No bitches.
Okay. Welcome, I've been expecting you.
Ugh.
Ugh. So cringe. Oh, I love it.
I am known as Damon. I am the guardian of the collective knowledge of our world. So, you're looking for the sorceress Zenobia. Without guidance, you'd never find her. She'll next appear in Reza, a girl named Lily. Lily, get that? Lily is her next victim. Beware, adventurers. Zenobia is strong, but Galleon is stronger again?
Alex is like, dude, I fucking saw Galleon. He threw a bunch of rocks at little bugs, dude. That guy, he's fucked up.
He sucks.
Unless you become like a dragon master, Alex, there's no hope for our world. I don't know if this is still the dude or not.
It is.
Still the guy, yeah.
But now that Quark has been murdered, that's interesting. Many of the books in my library focus on prophecies concerning our world.
and one of them has to do with how I have no heir. Did you know that? I have no heir. No,
not a single heir.
You should
read through a few of them and, you know, maybe linger on that Arato one.
He's like, he's like, video games. Video
blades. This hurts me because I know that this is the voice of, like, 15 dudes who messaged Kelly on AIM trying to send her things.
Oh, no.
To send.
Oh, hello, my lady.
Just send her things. You could have stopped.
Sure. I love that how he has a bunch of, like, you know, books about prophecies and then probably an erotic novel and then his diary, and that's what's on his book.
That's it. He's like, this is the collective knowledge of the entire world. There's nothing else but this. I like how I used items because I was like, boss fight, and then here I am like, oh well, okay, but at least Kyle learned the magic of sidestep, so. Kyle's like, hey, I got this fucking magic spell. Watch this. Hold on, watch this shit. Watch, I learned this spell. All you motherfuckers are doing magic and shit. Watch this. He's like, ha, see? Fuck firebombs and shit. Dragon magic. That's for pussies. Sidestep.
I don't know why, but I thought you were gonna unleash your ass.
The whole thing? My vigor peach? Yeah.
Yeah,
bigger
peach.
Oh, wow. Wait, Francis!
What?
Use the spell to get out of here, bro. You don't want to just have.
Oh, yeah, here. Mia has that motherfucker now, doesn't she?
Wait, no, I think Jessica does. Right? Is it? It's called. Wait,
no.
No. Is it
Mia's got it. Psychotron. Which
that should have worked.
Oh.
Wait, what the fuck?
Oh.
Uh oh. Kyle, sidestep! Get us out of here!
Step right through the wall.
John, what did I tell you about distributing those roses? Absolutely not.
AIM out about... Oh my god, John! Not an AIM rose, holy shit.
Wait, do you have to run back through this then?
I sure do.
Apparently. Through these, Hanova followers.
Jesus.
Well,
there wouldn't be a Lunar game if you didn't have to backtrack.
Pfizer, oh my god.
That's how you actually get to grind.
Yeah, so, like, I was talking a little bit about this on the podcast we did yesterday, but, like, I think one thing that you see a lot in older RPGs especially is that, like, the game will force you to backtrack because it's trying to make sure that you're a certain level.
Oh my god, all these have fucking books. Alright, chat, chat, do you want books, chat? If chat wants books, we'll read some books, but if chat doesn't, we will move on.
You should just read them and then just not have to read them out loud. I think that's probably the
best. If I see a good one, okay.
Yeah. If you see a good one, like, read the line or whatever.
AR.
I always vote yes to torturing the streamers.
No,
oh!
Yeah, but Vice
oh. That healed me!
Yeah, heal book.
Gave me. Oh, wait, no, it didn't. What did it do? It didn't do anything, actually.
Did it give you. Oh, yeah.
What the fuck?
Did it cause the battle?
Maybe, actually.
That's it. Alright, it's time to fast cut.
Ooh.
I still, all of these fucking spells, I have, like, no, I know Calm Litany heals everybody, and Lil Litany hears one person. All that other shit, literally no cure.
Never used it.
It's a surprise.
Just to
wow,
your way
good
through.
Job. Good job, Kyle. Fast cut.
Oh, wait, hold on. Could you just use the wings? Frank, I think you can just use the wings from the room, man.
Oh, let's see.
Because I know you can teleport here. Any other versions, so I mean, the other room, like where Damon is.
We'll get there.
Well, maybe one day
we're gonna get
there.
Seven encounters to get there.
Yeah. nobody look.
Yeah, if you don't look, it changes the RNG scene. I looked. I've turned into both a pillar of salt and a pillar
and
of frank salt. And stone, yeah.
And stone, yeah.
Alright, so use those, you damn weed.
There we go, thank God. Alright, so I think we go to Reza now.
Yeah, yeah.
Man, I walked out of this. Because I thought I couldn't.
You know why, John? Because your brain is too large for Lunar the Silver Star.
Where I need to find, why isn't there just fucking goddamn inns in this game? Can I
teleport to Vayne. Teleport to Vayne and talk to the guy standing out front.
Okay. That's a good idea. That's a good idea, because that is one thing where I'm like, Jesus, they're like, here's the town. Now walk fucking 8 miles to a place near it, and then you're good. We'll heal you. And I'm like, please, no, I don't wish to do that. Please.
And I think Lily is the little girl in, so you go to Reza, and then you talk
it's
to
the dancer, singer
gets,
lady.
Like, kidnapped or whatever, yeah. And then this is actually really similar in the other version. And by the way, the other versions of this game also have the same issue where there's no inns. Everything is just healed through the statues.
They usually keep them inside the, in the towns, I remember, I think.
Yeah, there should be one in every town. It's just a matter of finding it.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Let's see if
we can find where she is. Is this her? Oh no! This is the fucking secret.
Oh, gambling.
Here, hold on. Why don't I just look at the thing? That'll show me exactly who to talk to.
Yeah, I'm not sure where she is.
I'm pretty sure she's in the Thieves Guild because she's the little girl who gets kidnapped. Spoilers.
Well, that's not really spoilers. We kind of got told that was happening.
That's true.
My expression looks like I'm being actively wooed by an NFT trader. I don't know what that means, but okay.
Oh, here
sometimes
we go.
You just totally zone out.
Oh, did you guys hear the music change? They just added I like how they're playing both musics at the same time. Ooh. It's kind of Genesis farty sounding.
My music brain does not like that.
No,
both of them at once, it's not good.
Yeah, I think that was a glitch, bro.
A lady came the other day who said that she'd take me on a tour of the land. I've been thinking about going with her, but I think Grandpa'd really be worried if I left.
Rachel, I think that you're a Zenobia.
I can feel that.
My what? What?
You're this Zenobia. Is Zenobia.
Oh my god.
Okay. Girl boss Karen.
Oh god.
Girl boss Karen.
You fools again.
It's a little witchy too.
We finally caught up with you. Return Luna to us immediately.
Sorry, I can't do that. You little flying freakette. I've disposed of her.
Fuck yeah.
She's at Master Galeon's lair, relaxing, I'm sure. As soon as I take Lily here, my job will be completed. See you on the frontier.
The happy music mixed with the bad music right now is just so much.
Terrible.
And she's just like, I'm out.
I don't know why, but I do a real good villain voice.
Hell yeah.
Alex, we have to hurry to the frontier. Luna has got to be in grave danger.
And no more farty music. We're done with the farts.
Also,
Sega farts are a real fucking music genre.
Also, my dog, while I was doing that voice, was really amused and wanted to jump up on my lap.
Yeah, you know what? Riker was... You summoned Riker with that, too. He just, like, came over to me and was just like, hey, I'm an asshole. What's up?
What's up?
Fascinating.
We got the pupper.
Go to Damon's Spire.
Yep. And then go west.
Okay, I know I was gonna grab Alex some steel armor here real quick.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
Get my boy armored up. And
so
I gotta
sell some
stuff.
Yeah, you probably should.
How about
sell
the speed ring?
Yeah,
how about the speed ring? Does anyone know if there's a speed ring in Final Fantasy VII?
Please.
This is really important.
It's gonna be the like, eventually it'd be like, Frank, sell the auto haste ring. I won't do it!
Bro, what do you want? What the fuck could you possibly want? All your needs are taken care of.
And wanders off.
I hate my dog. I hate him. I don't know what he wants in life, and I can't ascertain that information, because he won't talk to me.
For he is a dog.
For he is a dog.
And Frank's broke.
And
am I?
You broke Frank.
How? Wait, where am I broken?
No, you're like broke.
Oh, okay. I was like, that fucking goddamn streaming has me ruined. I'm like, we're broke. We're broke. What happened? I'll fix it.
Oh, speaking of which, I never checked the audio.
I think we're not
doing it. No one's complained, so I think we're good.
Yeah. I keep forgetting. Also, Alex will start getting really good gear soon.
Cool.
Frank, you've been muted this entire time.
No, fuck off. I've done dialogue. I know this is a lie.
People did respond. But maybe they could hear you through our speaker.
At this point, viewers can probably just like figure out what I'm doing.
I'm just close enough to Frank that I can actually hear him if I open the door.
That would read.
Aren't you guys like 3 hours away from each other too?
Not
like,
anymore. Like, we could get to each other in like, yeah, like 20, 30.
That's wild.
Just you wait. Eventually, we're going to do the John fixes stuff on stream. That's all Vicer wants out of life is just like, I just want to watch John fix tech and talk about it calmly. And I'm like, that's a great idea. Same. I love that.
Got a GameCube that needs a chip in it.
See?
Why don't you put that chip in there, brother? Record that chip. Record that chip. Folks, if you like what you see, if you see what you like, go ahead and give us a like, give us a sub, give us some fucking bits, because if you want to see John fix something, you gotta pay him.
You gotta.
Let me tell you, this is an adult male. He's not gonna work for free. Those times...
What kind of fucking society do you think this is?
This is a capitalist. I
work 10 hours a day to get paid very well.
No. And now you're going to work 2 hours to get paid very little, so deal.
Exactly. Nothing, because Frank will get it.
It goes back to the show.
All of our money goes to Frank to fuel his severe gambling addiction.
Yes, exactly.
And buy him vape.
Yes, I buy fucking vape juice, weed, and I gamble. That's it. That is all the parts of my personality.
Every time Frank hits the vape, it's just all of your bits going up in smoke.
Can John fix poor Darnell though? That's the real question.
No.
Bless.
Joey's dead. I just watched Joey's soul leave his fucking body. Thank you, Six.
Trying to pull him back in.
Well, you killed Joey. Congratulations.
I haven't heard a poor Darnell joke in a long time. That was, you've been saving that up.
A classic character.
He was waiting till the opportune moment.
Yeah, he was making that like a good stew, just letting it marinate. Yeah,
let it marinate.
It's good soup.
Good soup?
Am I going the right way? Who fucking knows? It's Lunar, baby. Everything looks the same. I did it! I went the right way! Oh, there's a fucking shrine right there. No, there's a shrine right here.
Oh, yep. Hell yeah. That's
an MP healer, I think.
Yeah, that is.
Volcano, though.
I am so proud that you went the right way.
Me too, honestly, because it can really fucking go the wrong way.
I spent hours lost in this game I tried to play it by myself. It was bad. For parts of it. But some parts you just get lost in the world map.
Yeah, even with a guide.
It can be very confusing, for sure.
Yeah, I couldn't find a good world map guide, in all honesty.
No, there's not a world map I could find at all. That was my problem.
I hate to see it. what do you use here? The
I could have sworn I used
the jump button.
The jump button, the secret jump button.
Is it this where I used rain the rain cloud?
Yeah, maybe. Try it.
It's not working.
No. Hold on.
No.
That's 100%
the rain cloud to cool the lava.
Yeah, that's what I'm looking at. Oh, okay. Oh, I don't use it, guys. I don't use it from the inventory.
You need an exact right pixel.
Yeah. Alex, look. Whew, that made it cool in here.
Wow, isn't that fucking wonderful? Wow, Alex.
That's amazing.
Wow, Alex, that's fucking crazy, bro. I can't fucking believe that shit, man. That's crazy.
This dungeon in complete is actually kind of tough. It's probably one of the harder things in the game, I think. This and the water dungeon have enemies that are really fucking annoying. Like
the look of these walls is really interesting.
It looks higher res than a lot of the other sprites.
Yeah.
It's like the art style and it's different. Yeah, my guess is that they probably had multiple environmental artists and this is a different one, or one you don't see as often or something. Believing that there's a rare bone for those with macular
raw bone.
That's a raw bone for those with macular. Yeah.
Wait, what is a raw bone a phrase? If it is a phrase, I've never heard that before. I'm gonna Google this because I'm stupid. A raw bone.
Yeah, Google that. That's a great idea.
It's a six phrase.
That's a six phrase.
Six made it up.
All I'm saying is that I said raw bone and Riker looked up at me. So
he's like, huh? What's up?
Huh? Bone? What?
Who?
What's up, Dad?
What are you doing, dude? Do you have a poo in your ass?
A whole poo?
A whole one. Not
that's
a half of one.
Oh.
Not a part of one.
We're going to have to wait. You're trying to do shit. Go lay down.
He hasn't got a single treat tonight, and he's upset.
Someone, can someone, if someone fucking subscribes right now, Joey is going to give Riker such a treat. Such a fucking treat. It's true.
Give him a treat.
Go ahead.
I was going to say, he's just addicted to weed.
It's true. There we go.
What were you going to say, Kel?
Oh, there's an entire pizza in the fridge. No, there's not.
No, there's not.
Actually.
Why
good
is
for Riker.
In your ass got picked up by the flag.
Bro, everything ever gets picked up by the fucking flag, I swear.
Might have the flags turned a little high.
We just turn them down. Yeah. I think we'll turn them down like a level.
I don't think I can access the bot, so I'm leaning on John for that one.
I can do it.
Well, you're playing
we're
a video
Sage's
game.
Clothes. Yeah, well, that's true. That's a good point. That's a real good point, actually.
Moderation. Let's see.
I think it's under auto mod settings somewhere. Rachel, do you have the auto mod settings on your stream?
I don't think so. Like, I know when I'm viewing other people's streams, for whatever reason, it will, like, you know, censor what other people type, and I have to be, like, approve. And it's like, these are in your parental control settings or in your, like, you know, privacy settings, security settings and stuff. And I have looked everywhere in Twitch, and I can't figure out how to disable these.
That's the auto mod setting that's what I'm talking about. Six just said in your ass and it got flagged.
It said no.
Like just the phrase in your ass got flagged. That was the thing. And I get it because like there are things you can say as an insult to that. Like,
but no, like when I'm watching other people's streams, I have to like there's words that are like blacked out and I'm just like, okay. So I can't figure out how to disable whatever setting I have enabled.
It's profanity filter.
Yeah, no, I can't find it anywhere. So
I think it's under chat settings. Like if you go into the cog, it's like chat filter off.
Yeah, it is off.
Interesting.
Everything is
you
off.
You have to do it for like every stream that you go and watch, I feel like.
It's so weird. But I will say that what's really funny is that I can't use like my Prime sub on any other like account but my own. It's like permanently subbed to myself, and I can't figure out how to
Yeah, so if you go into the your account and you hit the resubscribe thing, you can
see this is a huge fucking dungeon. Holy shit.
It is a big dungeon.
Big old dungeon,
under
yeah.
subscriptions.
All right, I have taken the mod down one step on everything.
All right, someone say hick. Say something. Yes, someone say hick. Someone say something slightly offensive, but nothing that you would get banned for. Okay. Noob hick. Oop, okay, well, hicks. That one's still getting... That's okay. We've permitted noob hicks. It's okay, Super RPG friends, really, like...
It looks like Turd made it through, finally.
Creeping it here.
You know what's really funny? I'm in my subscriptions right now on my, like, tab, and there's no way to, like, edit it at all.
Speaking of subscriptions, if you have Amazon Prime, don't forget that you have a free once a month Amazon Prime sub, and this is the best place to do it, folks. This is the best place to use it. What does this fucking jewel do? It's just a jewel, that's all. They're like, yo, you want some fucking money? We got you. Where did it go? Jewel.
Okay, nope. You can't say that.
We need some endgame money.
Jesus, Pfizer, control yourself.
can we take that off of the auto mod now? You could say Final Fantasy 13 finally.
Okay, no, I feel like I'm the resident FF13.
It's not on the auto mod.
Officially.
Like, you could.
I'm more upset
about
the curry.
The curry is upsetting.
Wait, what about the curry?
Six said curry is trashed here.
Wow, we don't talk like that in this house. I love curry.
Wait, what?
We might have to figure out how to filter that.
Wait, yeah. Hold on. That didn't show up in my text. I'm not even joking, dude. That didn't even show up on my chat. What?
You have a curry filter on, Joe.
Yeah, my own eyes.
Joey the curry filter.
How do you hate curry? Dude, okay, oh, never mind. You live in Florida. I get it.
I love curry. He's got no excuse.
Love curry.
Local curry. Local Florida curry, though, man. That's
no bueno, no cap. Fuck off, brother. I will not stand for that kind of slander. I love curry.
Six.
Like,
y'all, I have good news.
What?
I figured it out.
Did you?
Your profanity filter.
Oh yeah! Curry, yo, you better give that dog some treats, baby. Alright, fine. Come here, you dang animal.
They're even running around in the background like they know.
I'm listening carefully.
Bump bump boo do 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 do.
Such epic music.
AI. I don't even know. I don't think I've had the AI do much more than attack in this game.
AI.
We're singing fucking... What? Oh, hold on. I don't. I need to, though. Oh, look at them dogs! Look at them puppies!
They're so excited. Look at them.
They're just waiting for that bag to spill.
They are.
Yeah, it's gonna spill.
They're like, please, father. You don't have to do this.
They're starving.
Could someone tell me what mint essence fucking does in this game?
Yeah, hold on.
And vigor peaches. Honestly, I need both.
Frankie, you know what a vigor peach does.
You know, I think I do, but I don't.
Mint essence cures paralysis.
Wow, I'm so happy I went out of my way for that. What about the vigor peach?
I think that's a full heal, but
well, that's not bad.
Yeah, it's a full HP heal.
Okay, fuck off.
What about just real herb of Althena? Sorry to use you.
I think that's 100 HP.
I think that's max HP.
That's everyone's full. Everyone's full
HP. Oh yeah, we're gonna go grab that for sure.
I just realized that it is raining at my house.
Dude, it's been... We've had, like, a good week and a half of nonstop fucking Florida rain, honestly.
Like, I mean, it rained last night. Like, that was some rain yesterday. Like, my internet flickered. That's how bad that rain was. But before that, it didn't rain for, like, a while. But I have noticed
where I'm
that,
at,
like,
it seems...
have noticed Sorry. That the last couple of days, though, like, normally we get a rainstorm right at, like, 3 o'clock, right? Now it's going to, like, okay, we're going to get one right at, like, 5 o'clock.
Fucking ass, 6.
Yeah.
Oh. See, yeah, mine's, like, 2, 3 o'clock every day.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all all really have, like, a daily rain?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because we live in a subtropical climate.
My neighborhood finally got to that point where I'm like, it rains a little bit and the water stays, and I'm like, oh god, my ground is saturated. That means we're ready to flood. If we get 2 hours of like heavy rain, my neighborhood's gonna be fucking waterlocked. I'm gonna be waterlocked, brother. Yeah. No, I won't be able to get out. That's the problem.
Six finally showing his true Florida colors. That's all I'm saying.
I will say the best thing about the like part of the state that I live, it is kind of, it's pretty high above sea level. So when the state inevitably sinks further into the sea, I will have waterfront property.
Hell yeah.
He's complaining about so lightning. Fancy.
Long-term, yeah, like a long-term investment. Nice.
That's
just
worth
more
some
Final
money.
Fantasy 13 beating.
Oh no. I was thinking of 10 for some reason.
6, let me tell you, I don't trust it either. When I leave my house, all of my important like things are unplugged. Like computer unplugged, PS5 unplugged, like all that stuff unplugged.
I just have backup batteries for everything.
No, I mean I have one. I just haven't like I have a, you know, a UPS system. But
I
haven't plugged it in
UPS
yet because
the first time
you plug it in, sometimes it has that, you know, just weird new plastic smell.
It was bad.
Well, it was just really it was just really plasticky smelling, and I was like, I'm just gonna leave this here for a little bit, unplugged forever, and not plug it in until I have a friend over that knows more about hardware stuff than I do, to tell me whether or not this is just bad or it's just plastic smell coming out of packaging. So,
I'm
real good with software, hardware not so much.
I ordered an electric kettle that you could not get the smell of plastic
out
of. What
the fuck?
Like, it was like impossible.
Yeah.
Like, washed it with soap, washed it with Coke, did everything that we could to just,
Jesus, Northern Juggalo electronic anxiety. Oh, wait, do you mean NJEA? Yeah, NJEA. It's a very common phenomenon around here.
Pretty sure it's in the DSM-5.
Yeah, it might be.
Well, it will be when that gets there.
Now that I think about it.
Jesus Christ.
Can't wait for the DSM.
That brings
game.
Me back to college, taking abnormal psychology, looking at the DSM-5.
Did you guys notice I got some new glasses tonight? I can't save in this fucking room. You have, that's true. God, I'm absolutely.
I
probably can. I'll give it a try.
I'd have to edit it.
I should be good. I could throw it in Canva. It should be easy.
Luckily, you're almost done with this dungeon because all that's pretty much left is you go there and then you can teleport out.
Is there a boss?
No, not in
No? Oh, fuck yeah, baby!
I wonder if that was like intended or not, but wait, is there a boss? Actually, I don't know.
Oh, young adventurers! Oh, hold on. Actually, hold on.
Here we go. Voice modulator, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
If it'll turn on right.
I already know.
You felt it.
I felt it in my bones.
Oh, young adventurers, I am the Red Dragon. My spirit is fading, but never here leave my power.
There you guys go. You're welcome.
That was anticlimactic.
He was just kind of like, I'm fucked.
We got both a sing mode and Joey explaining it.
Oh no.
What am I explaining? Okay. Or, yeah, actually,
Nox, nice to see you, Nox.
What I have to say.
Nice to see you, Nox.
I hate Frank. And the other versions of this game. have a lot. This dungeon's a little bit more complicated. There's like a there's a boss fight here, and then in this one you can just peace out.
I almost left without this fucking shield. I just want to mention that. I was almost like, all right, time to peace out. Like, there you go.
Alex, look, that has to be the shield of the red dragon.
Learn the dragon fire spell. This is not, there's not followers and subs, and every time I hear these sounds, I'm like...
Ooh, what?
Fucking you up.
Tempter.
Oh, hell yeah, no, it's nice.
So my first initial response was when I saw sing mode, I was like, no, I'm too tired to sing.
Good, you know what, let's keep it that way, because I wish Frank were too tired to sing too, but he loves to see me in pain.
It's
so
true.
I am in pain.
Literally one of my number one things.
He's been hanging out till sing mode.
Heard the joke.
Been hanging out till like, sing mode.
Like, nope, drove me off. Goodbye.
Yeah. Yeah, thank you for that. All right, see you guys. Take care. Nice to hang. If you don't want your dogs anymore, let me know. If you would like to come over and take these dogs for a walk right now, I would really appreciate
that. Yeah, please, come right on by. Give them some snacks.
Nox, where do you live anyway? Or you don't have to say that if you don't want.
Just
but,
general area.
Yeah.
It's fine.
I will spoil
what's
that
your,
more than you can.
What's your zip code, brother?
Yeah, well, it's also like your social security number so I can like, cross-reference that with mine.
I just need the last four. It's okay.
Yeah, that's
cool.
Really,
I don't need the
I
whole thing.
The
latitude and longitude readings, please.
Yeah, share your location.
We need coordinates.
Yeah, it's important. I don't really spoil my dogs, I have to say. Like, they get treats and they cuddle and stuff and they can lay on the couch when they want. But
oh,
like,
dude, I got this dumb little idiot dog and I give him anything he wants because he's so fucking cute. I can't handle it. I wish I could. Wow, hey guys! Yeah, I just want everyone to know my guide was like, yeah, just fucking buy Alex a samurai sword, 10,000. Buy Kyle a greatsword, 12,000. A flail, 7,300, and a boomerang. It's no problem. Like, whatever. Fuck it. Just buy it. It's no problem. You totally have the fucking money for this. Listen.
You spent like 20 grand on armor. Sell
Listen.
Your jewelry there.
So,
speed ring.
Yeah, speed ring, too.
Oh, God, the speed ring.
So, yeah, I feel like that's a possible destination.
Six has asked a good question. Streamers other than Frank, what was the first game you paid full price for?
I did Vicer, and that game was super fun. I think that it's a low bar, but Tina's Wonderland's probably the best Borderlands game, so.
I like
low
the game
bar.
Borderlands
yeah, it was special. Well, that's my thing, is that they perfected the gameplay of it in 3, but everything else surrounding 3 was so fucking horrible. That, like, with Tina's Wonderland, it made me realize that, oh my god, they need to leave this franchise behind, because giving them the chance to do these, like, full-color, inventive environments and stuff like that works so much fucking better than just, like, welcome to Pandora, we got, deserts.
I was waiting for Frank to finish talking, because I am a polite human being.
Please, I'm sorry.
No, it's okay. So I think, actually, it was relatively recently, I had followed this game be developed for a little while by a French company, and the game is called Edge of Eternity. It looks really like a pretty game, and it is a pretty game, and the music is pretty, but just, oh my god, the combat and just the dialogue and everything else about it is just not good. And it's made by a small company with big dreams.
The artwork is cool. The artwork is sick.
So everything about it looks absolutely sick, but then the characters open their mouths and you hear the dialogue. And I think mainly really what it was is it's by a French company, and which is, you know, usually produces pretty good things. I mean, that's where we got Kodioko. So...
With Edge of Eternity, everything I heard was they were like, I really, really, really wanted to like this game. It seems to be like the general consensus I hear about
it. I really wanted to like it, but like, and it, good setup, whatever, combat was pretty cool, you know? But
Buongiorno.
Just, they opened their mouth, and I was like, oh, honey.
Oh, honey, please.
Oh, honey, you're trying too hard, honey.
Whoa, hey, but, guys. Look where we arrived to.
Oh, no.
This is the spring of the goddess Althena. If you enter its soothing waters, you can beautify your body. Do you wanna? Oh, that sounds great. Oh, one other thing I failed to mention. Only woman can enter into the spring. I know, it's discriminatory. But hey, it's tradition, alright? I mean, fucking holy shit, I mean, come the fuck on.
Six.
Are you guys ready?
Woo,
here we are, yay! We're having fun.
That was all we get.
Well, it was more tastefully done than I thought it would be.
Honestly, yeah, that was better than I was expecting. That was better than my memory card sticker that I had on my PlayStation 1 memory card.
Nox, I will say, sometimes the Kodoko theme song just pops into my head for literally no apparent reason.
It is a good theme song.
It's a bop.
Most of the Kickstarter money went to Mitsuda.
I did pay full price for Unlimited Saga.
I'm so sorry.
That's not that bad.
No, that's not that bad.
It's not terrible, but...
Well, you could have definitely spent your money on something
else. I actually try not to pay full price for any game.
Same, I try not to unless I play it right away.
And yeah, Nox, I can fully understand that, because the music in Edge of Eternity does slap, and it's because it's by Mitsuda. So...
Maybe it's worth actually, playing for that. I have it. It was like $20.
Dragon Riders of Pern.
Oh no.
Because I really enjoyed the books, and I got, suckered.
The question was originally, what's the first game that you bought full price for that you regret, right? And, like, are you talking, like, with my parents' money or my own? Because that's an important distinction.
We actually talked about that.
I didn't even think about that.
We talked about that on the last stream, and I think we were talking about, on the premium edition one, I think we were talking about, like, parent ones. And I know for me, he brought me up to a horrible memory I have. I was really into fucking Addams Family when I was a kid. During the Super Nintendo days.
I remember
having, no, it's not any better than Fester's Quest in all fucking honesty. One of the Super Nintendo Addams Family games, I remember I got it. I had my parents buy it for me. Like, full price and everything, and oh my god, it was so fucking bad. Like,
Huxley's Adventure or something?
Probably, yeah. It was when they were like, go for it, sorry.
No, it's okay, I'm just remembering now the Addams Family game that was on the Game Boy, or the Game Boy Color, and how bad that one was. Yeah.
I didn't even know there was a Game Boy one.
Like, the only reason I own it is because, this was right after Dragon Con in 2019, and I had dressed up as Morticia and my friend was Gomez. When we came back and I went to a local con, it was just me. One of my favorite retro game stores in the area just came, like, one of their owners came up to me and just put the game in my hand and closed my hand and goes, "This is for you." And I went, "Okay." And I played it, and I literally went to their store the next day after the con was done and was like, "Why did you give me this? This is awful."
I hate it. Thank you.
Did they take it back?
Oh, hey, Joey, yeah, do you know what this town is? Do you know what this town is full of?
I don't want to talk about it.
Do you know what this town is full of? This is the Village of Lighten. Welcome to the Village of Lighten. Joey, it's Bards. There's a lot of singing. There's a whole lot of singing coming here.
Does this mean all of us have to sing the words when we read the dialogue?
Absolutely. Look at this man with a large hat. There's your character motivation. He's got a big hat.
Oh god. Who wants to go first?
Not it.
I wish I was sad song,
a lonely cry from afar. A beautiful, sad song.
Oh my god.
We love songs, but we hate sad ones.
All right, John's kind of working on me a little bit, but the rest of it sucks.
So beautiful, John. So beautiful.
Oh, who's got the Black Dragon song? And I want, with the Black Dragon song, I want black metal. Actually,
like some
metal. Joey, can we call Ren really quick and bring him in for this?
Okay, yeah, but I need gallops, so like.
Perfect. Oh my god. This is peak Super RPG Friends right now, folks.
Your advisor's saying I would have ended it long ago, or I would have gone.
I couldn't live in the village. This is the ant arc of this anime. Yeah, we gotta find Murim of this town, the fucking king of the chimera ants. Yeah.
We're not kids. We're actually adults, even though we're small.
You're welcome.
I fucking hate this village. So look, when I was replaying this game, I got to the part. And I knew that we were going to be playing Lunar Silver Star, and I was like, I'm going to try not to be on this episode.
On this episode.
And here you are.
But here we are.
Here you are. Okay, which one of us is
next?
Yeah,
who's got this one?
It's either you or me, Kelly.
Ooh, Nox. Damn.
I'll get it over with. Okay. I'll get it over with.
Okay, go ahead. Go. I'll take the last one.
Long, long ago, a boy named Dine came to the Dragon Blue. He found the door to the Cave of Blue beneath the waterfall. Beneath the waterfall!
Literally beautiful.
The pain that Joey is going through is so real.
Joey's favorite town in any RPG. This is why this NPC stays indoors. The black. Oh wait, never mind. We know about the black dragon.
We know all about the black dragon.
Zenobia has taken my daughter. Why now?
Oh,
I can't sleep at night, so she's gone. She's gone. Oh, why did this happen to me?
I can't wait till Joey is just like, Frank, I hurt myself last night. Thank you for that.
Unfortunately, Super RPG Friends is only going to be Frank and John.
That's it. From now on.
This episode. Thank you guys for the continued support.
I'm over here, like, ready for the perfect person talking.
Yeah, let Rachel sing.
Rachel, do you want to do a sad song?
Oh, God, I don't know if I can sing a sad song.
I can hear a sad song, a lonely cry from afar, a beautiful sad song. We love songs, but we hate sad ones.
Damn, he made his way all the way to the bottom of the fucking village earlier. What the hell?
He did.
Who wants to be the magician?
He's just talking.
Yeah, this guy is just fucking talking. He's just like, this guy is just like.
Have this one, Joey.
Yeah, please, Joey. Please be the magician who's just sick of this fucking shit.
I'm the magician here. I had a dream about a boy.
A boy! A single word.
He's not doing it.
I can't even fucking hear you, Joey. Just like,
your noise canceling is just too good.
I have never made out with my mic like that, but here I do. My name is Alex!
Oh, see, Alex. Let me break the curse place down the river.
Boom.
Now Alex can cross.
Your heart split. Your heart split. Go for it.
I said, you sound like you're doing slam poetry.
Your heart split of Alex into two syllables? Like, it's masterful.
If I was doing slam poetry, you would have to, like, wait, talk to him again, Frank? It'd be like... Oh. It'd be like, now go to the cave of the blue dragon. You're Alex with the green eyes.
Yep, yep.
It's like a absolutely William Shatner, you know?
That's a good way of putting it. It's a little William Shatner-esque.
I feel like your first interpretation was channeling Matthew McConaughey from True Detective Season 1.
I felt the existential death that he went through during that season. So, yeah, in a way I was, for sure. It hurt. Grieving John Waters.
Holy shit.
That's so good, dude. Oh my
God.
So, anytime
Vicer, God, these jerks are literally just putzing around. Walking around with their fucking stupid hats, just waiting to sing at strangers. What is this, a fucking indie concert in a fucking tiny bar?
Yeah, this is like a My Little Pony hangout session, man. I hate it.
They're like, la, la, la,
like a collection of hats.
Yeah, exactly. Rachel's too good at that, man. I'm kind of scared.
What, that?
Yeah, that was too good. You lived the trauma.
Yeah. I also was in theater for a number of years, so I'm
so sorry.
I gotta find me a heel. I feel like this is a good spot to get some kills in. The fucking guy just like, hey, just casually get everyone up to level 40 at this point. And I'm like,
yeah,
no,
right. Fuck off, mate.
Dude, every single one of these walkthroughs for any game that I've used one through is so like, yeah, just fucking take like 4 hours to grind, dude. Whatever, it's no big fucking deal. What are you, a pussy? Like.
Yeah, I mean, it was the 90s. They could use those words. And they did.
Liberally.
Yeah. if you read any guide, they call you slurs and stuff, too. It's fucked up.
Fucking game facts, bro.
The whole of Northern Florida is trauma. It's
Florida is trauma.
Yeah, I mean, especially Northern Florida, because it's just a magnet for hurricanes. So,
I'm driving up to Destin this weekend.
Destin's not bad.
Well, I say Destin because then people know where I'm talking about, but it's like...
It's like when people ask me where I live, and I'm like, yeah, I live in Tampa.
Fort Walton.
Fort Walton? That's what I thought. I was like, where are you going, Fort Walton?
It's where my in-laws are.
Oh, yeah.
You made up the name of these things.
I think the reason I drove through Fort Walton is I was going to the base that's there near Fort Walton.
The Eglinton big one. Or
Eglin, yeah.
Eglin Air Force Base, yeah.
Yep.
So. They probably keep him there to protect us from him. Yeah.
John needs to be like handicapped. His power is too great.
Ooh, now it's pouring.
I will say, yeah, it is raining here too, so. I will say Pensacola is a good time.
Fuck Florida.
Florida military base talk. John and Rachel.
That's the new podcast. This is the first Super RPG Friends spinoff, is Florida military base talk.
No, just Florida talk.
Stick
all the Floridians on the show and just talk Florida.
You get Florida talk. It's gonna happen.
We do this thing on Cerulean Skies called Coffee Talk, and it's supposed to be like a chill stream, like, you know, like basically a just chatting stream. And Golden plays the game, the VN Coffee Talk, while his guests sip a coffee and just chat. And I'm feeling like that's the next logical step of that segment. Wait, did Frank just leave?
He walked away to grind and do something.
Honestly, really efficient.
Nox, I will say, yes, you are 100% correct. The more north that you go in Florida, the southern it gets. And the opposite is also true. The more south you go, the more north it gets. Because tons of people from the northern states just migrate down here and buy all of the houses. So, literally all of them. Except except for Miami. Miami basically belongs to the Cubans at this
point. It's a hellhole. I love Miami. It's great.
As it should. As it should. I consider Chicago and Illinois different states. To be honest, like they're completely different. Like it's
the Keys
not
is a
close.
Weird place though.
It's like Missouri and St. Louis.
Oh yeah, that's true.
Yeah, I could see that. I could see that.
The Keys is a weird place though. Totally weird. Have you ever been to the Keys, the Florida Keys?
I haven't. It kind of scares me.
It's a strange place. Very strange.
I really only read the Stephen King book about it.
It's accurate.
Wait, what book is it, Kelly?
Duma Key.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
It's very accurate. Like, driving through the Keys in the dead of night is very, both awe-inspiring and terrifying, because everything closes down to a one-lane road because it's like that's when they do their construction is in the dead of night. So if you're coming back from Key West to go wherever it is that you're staying, which is not Key West, it's on one of the other keys, because it's expensive to stay on Key West, you have to, of course, like go like 15 under the speed limit just so you don't die by hitting some construction worker.
One time when I was driving back from a music festival in Miami, we lost 3 hours of driving time. Isn't that fun? We don't know what happened to it. We were like, well, how did it move forward 2 hours? Whatever. Have you ever gotten that where you just drive for so long that you're like, your body shuts down and just goes into like autopilot? It's the most bizarre shit.
I'm so glad that you clarified, because I thought this was about to become like UFO talk.
No, yeah, God, no. Post Ultra Music Festival, I don't blame you for thinking that Frank's just like, I was just flying, baby. Like, no.
What's the longest road trip you've done in a single sitting?
The longest I've gone to is Tennessee in a single drive.
How far of a drive?
It's a good... It was like a good 2 day drive. Like we stayed overnight one place on the way there.
Oh, I did 10.5 hours straight from St. Louis to New Orleans.
Damn. That's rough, man.
That was brutal. I stopped twice.
The Chicago to Memphis drive, and that's like about eight and a half hours.
8 hours. Well, it should be 8.5, but it wasn't.
Well, to be fair, you have to stop on. You have to stop in Boomland on the way there.
You have to stop in Boomland.
Is it Missouri or?
It's Missouri. It's St. Charles, Missouri.
Yeah. Missouri. John, have you ever been to Boomland?
No, but I've been to St. Charles.
How could you go to one and not the other?
I just black out during the drive.
It happens, see?
No, it, Missouri is like, you're driving through and it's just fireworks, Jesus, and porn.
Whoa.
That is exactly Boomland.
Whoa! Fire magic!
Boomland, yeah. Hold on, I think I have an Instagram video of this. Hold on. I'll find it, give me a minute. I know I do. But yeah, that's pretty much just Boomland.
Six, that's very sweet.
I like
but
that
yeah,
six.
Incredibly not stalkerish.
Yeah.
But sweet.
You know, a little bit of column A, a little bit of column B, you know?
Yeah.
It's hard to be romantic without being a little stalkerish.
True.
Depends on the
recipient. Romantic just means stalker in French. I know that.
There's Joey spitting the hard facts again.
I'm an expert of the French language. Here we go. This is Boomland, by the way. Not to plug my own Instagram that I haven't used in like 3 years.
Dude, you're trying to plug your Instagram, bro? Come on!
Yeah, I'm trying to build, I'm trying to like get people to buy my candles. This is just the first step.
Joey's RPG musk candles.
Oh, no.
Ew.
Oh.
It smells like an 8-hour speed run.
Bathwater. Some Vaseline. I put a bunch of Vaseline on. Like, I just cover my body in it and take a bath. I'm like the oily residue.
I think this is the second time on stream you've tried to hawk your bathwater.
It may be the fourth. I think.
It may be the fourth.
Well, you know what, man? A sale's a sale, John. So, you know, you can't really fault me, can you?
If you tried, you'd make you just a piece of shit.
Yeah, if you can, you're just trying to put down an honest man's living. That's all I'm saying. I'm not saying. I'm just saying.
Jesus Christ. Joie wraps his body in saran wrap and pays Kelly to dust his body with her ponytail, or vice versa.
What the
with
fuck?
His right.
I don't know how to make that into a sellable product.
Yeah. Is there a ponytail fetish? I'm sure there is.
I bet there's gotta be.
It's everything.
Listen, if they got grippers fetishes, there's for everything.
Wait, listen. Grippers fetishes?
Yeah, bro, grippers. Bro!
I will just say,
these
I
bad
just
boys.
Say, I will just say that Dry Bread, whatever it was that just wrote, I was just like, well, someone would buy that on an OnlyFans.
Yeah.
Six! I mean, six with the earnest? Dude, I love ponytails! I pay for it!
I love ponytails!
It's so earnest and, like, innocent. I love it.
Six! Desperate for pussy voice. I love ponytails.
I love ponytails, parentheses, with the intention to saran wrap.
Oh no!
Oh no!
That's what you could sell, the used saran wrap, Joie.
That's true.
Brilliant.
That's true.
Brilliant marketing.
Found it. That's a wrap.
Yeah, actually, Joey's latest candle is he really captured the essence of, you know, when like a dog takes a hot nap under a blanket and you pull that thing off of him and it's just all Cheetos factory or Frito factory.
Dude, it's Fritos. It's
Frito
Fritos
factory.
And Ireland.
Yeah, exactly. You got the candle for that.
Oh, actually, yeah.
Actually, as a matter of
the Joie explanation for this is that it's bacteria on their paws. Smell.
Fritos, yes, bacteria.
Fritos, yeah. My dog be dipping in the gamer stash, basically. Riker has just been like moving between all three beds, sitting on them and looking pathetic at me.
Of course.
I don't know what he
got treats already. What do they want?
He wants.
I don't know what the fuck
it
he
all.
Wants. He was out too.
The daily experience of living with Riker. What could he possibly want?
That's Shiro, bro. I get it. Shiro's constantly just up in my shit. Like, dude, you got everything. You got expensive food. You got mad pillows. Like, my dog, he literally almost refuses to use anything but a pillow when he goes to sleep. Like, he specifically speaks out, like, oh, I need to rest my little doggy head on here. And I'm like, bro, get a fucking job, dude. What the hell?
Yeah, like, pull some weight, you stupid
dude,
idiot.
Dude, you're
animal.
A corgi. Make a fucking Instagram, dude. What the hell?
Nox, look, if you want to come over, man, and hang out with some dogs, spoil them, be my guest. They're pissing me off right now. Feels like her head, her sweet little head is on my leg and she's giving me the Sarah McLachlan eyes. Nothing I can do to stop it. I just can't get rid of In the Arms of an Angel. It's
in
playing
the
in my head.
Arms of an Angel.
Wait,
come on
sorry,
down
were
to
you,
Billy
you
Mays!
Yeah, I hit it a long time ago and it's overflow now.
Billy Mays!
Capacity for one sing mode per episode.
Billy Mays here.
One line.
You ever run into an entire squad of flying fish? Well, do I have the spell for you? Dragon's Fire will kill every one of those motherfuckers in your way. And if they don't, your money back.
You're only five payments back. Of 1995 times
yeah.
shipping. That's right.
Yeah.
1995 times shipping.
With an plus easy MP payment.
Plus a speed ring.
Wait, Frank, what are speed. You doing, bro?
We're right before before a giant dungeon. So
I see.
I was like, all right, we got 10 minutes and a huge dungeon. So
remember the guy casually said, "Just be level 40."
Yeah.
So he's just casually getting to level 40.
Exactly.
Just casually, you know.
Remember, what's his name? Doan said he's like, yeah, I'm pretty much the level that you are now. And
when you beat
the
game,
final
yeah.
Five, yeah. You're like 8 MP away from beating the game.
Yeah. Wait, what level are you now, Frank?
39 on Alex.
Jesus Christ, dude. Damn.
But he's right near an MP heal, so it's an easy grind.
Exactly, so yeah, I'm just yeah. like, this is the spot. If there is ever a spot to make me actually grind between shows, this is it.
You're getting really close to an EXP ramp, though.
That worked, yeah.
That's the problem with this game. The game has huge EXP thresholds. Like, you hit one and it takes fucking forever to level up. I remember trying to grind in this game really hard as a kid because that was my thing. And I remember spending like 4 or 5 hours like with Alex and Ramses and Luna before the White Dragon Cave, and I was like level 12 or something for like a day.
And you fought another monster, and it gave you enough experience for like 3 levels, and you were like, "Fuck,
fuck." Yeah, I don't know. That was just my thing. I don't do that anymore unless it's like a job system game, and I'm like, "Ooh, I need to see all the jobs.
I need all the job points.
What little treats await me on the level ups?" Although I didn't really do it with Xenoblade 3, because I just needed to know what happened. Fritos are lower tier chips anyway, because one snack size will dehydrate you for a week. Well, that's why we had the hydrate command. Well, you're not wrong, Six.
No, he's really? Not. He's not wrong at all. You know what really, like, I didn't realize this until, like, just maybe a couple of weeks ago. We don't have barbecue Fritos anymore.
No, they're gone.
They're gone. You can only get them in Canada. You can only get them in Canada. That's the only place they are now, basically. And they're in other countries, randomly. But no. No more. Yeah. No more.
But go ahead. Do you have, like, the chili cheese Fritos, though? Like, yeah, not the chili cheese on them, flavored that way.
Yeah, but it's not the same. It's not the same. I mean, I love me some chili cheese Fritos, but I kind of like the barbecue sometimes.
I like the fucking barbecue twist.
Canada.
Honestly, I'm gonna message my Canadian friend. I'll be like, listen, I will pay you to send me some barbecue Fritos. And they'll be like, okay.
Listen, brother, I need them barbecue Fritos or else I'm about to die.
I remember
Fuck off,
I used to eat those for lunch all the time. Those, I would eat those and brown sugar and cinnamon Pop-Tarts.
Brown sugar and cinnamon Pop-Tarts.
That was like solid. My shit for like 2 years. And they were also the cheapest two things because the Pop-Tarts were, $0.50 and the Fritos were 50 cents. So you pay $1 and that was the best value you get, brother. And then I saved the rest of my money to buy DS games.
I have a question for you, Joey. I always believed that heating the Pop-Tart changed the flavor profile.
It does, man. It's a completely different flavor if you heat it. Some are better heated, I think.
And some are better cold.
Yeah, like the brown sugar ones especially change. It's a different thing. Me, personally, I like them both because I'm a piece of trash. You know what I'm saying?
Even if you let it go cold after it's been heated, it's still changed.
Yeah, fundamentally. Chemically changed. Well, I guess that's what heating is. But
denatured the proteins.
Yeah, exactly. But those proteins, man, they've been denatured many, many times.
Very denatured.
So
highly removed from nature.
I don't think there's anything natural about a Pop-Tart.
Except Wildberry, man. By the way, if you like look at Wildberry Pop-Tarts, like the if you do like a longitudinal study on Wildberry Pop-Tarts, you can see how they've been progressively nerfed throughout the years. Like they started out as like being covered in frosting, and then they stopped giving a fuck. If you look at a Wildberry Pop-Tart in the year of our Lord 2022, they look anemic.
Frosting's just barely plopped on there.
It's barely there, man.
Just
it looks
a little.
Like, it kind of looks like Frank's background.
Absolutely.
Like a lot of purple, a little blue. It was a thing, man.
Alright, let's see here. Let's do that, and then we're just about at that time.
We are.
Let's see. Boom. Oh wait, oops. I need to change that because this thing never wants to just let me pause.
There's a pause command on your teched out Sega CD.
Is there? Okay.
I don't know what it's defaulted to.
I'll just do that.
That works.
I thought you said improperly used map, and I'm like, yeah, they kind of do look like a shitty lunar map.
Nope, that worked exactly how it wasn't supposed to. It's okay, I fixed it. Anyway.
Oh.
So, dude, that fucking Red Dragon dungeon was huge. That was a good, like, that was a nice, like, 6 or 7 dungeon levels of multipath madness. That's the name of my new show, Frank Wood and the Multipath Madness. Whoa.
Diverse of paths.
So yeah. So we heard some real rednecks. We went for a nice hot spring visit. We met the biggest incel in the entirety of Lunar. That is his title. He Twitch streams under that. But yeah, it's definitely been a good one. We got a lot of shit done on that one, it feels like. And we got a lot of levels. We got a lot of good equipment upgrades. We're moving along, in all honesty. We're moving at a real good pace here.
I think we've had like 4 episodes left. Mm-hmm. 3 or 4 episodes.
We're definitely in the second half of the game. I can tell that.
Oh, yeah. You're like 65-ish% mm-hmm. through.
Rachel was tremendous. I also enjoyed Microdose Kelly.
Microdose? What is Microdose Kelly? And Kelly's John right now. So it's fine.
Oh, wonderful.
No, John's John too. We're back to being John.
We made
John.
It back.
We got double John.
John.
We're double John.
I need to fix this.
Cool. Don't worry about it.
You're just mad at her because she speed-ringed you, dude. It's fine.
I don't need this, like, vengeance.
Like, what, are you just calling me fucking John now? Really? Ugh!
I'm not saying.
I'm just saying. Oh, wait, yes. Hold on. Is that a little doggy action there?
Little
doggy? Yo. There he is. He says, Dad, I don't want to make my sounds into the microphone, Dad. Wait.
Ew. He licked it.
He was like, Dad.
What's up, buddy?
I hated doing that. I'm so sorry to each and every one of you who had to hear that sound.
I need to clean my headphones now.
I don't blame you.
Sending the anthrax to you now. So
we'll start with these two. John, Joey, do you guys have anything you guys want to say about tonight? And B, do you guys have anything you want to plug?
Just enjoying the laughs. Like everybody in chat.
Aww.
Been a good time.
Hell yeah.
Do you have anything to plug, John?
No, I don't plug nothing.
Being a handsome gentleman,
you know,
that's what he's plugging.
You know, I'm not a normal strimmer.
Well, John's getting some hair plugs next week, so he could finally have something to plug. honestly, dude, like, John, if you grew out your hair, I don't think that it would look full.
Oh yeah, it looks fine. Like, I just don't want to have to maintain both parts.
I see. For some reason, I was like under the assumption that like you had balded and that's why you shaved. But now that I'm looking, it's like, no, you still got.
No, you still got a full head of hair.
Yeah.
I got a little creep back in the corners here, but you know, it's mostly just gray at this point.
Yeah.
I blame SharePoint.
I blame your job, honestly, more than anything else. That's really what the cause of it.
Joey, are you just plugging like John's hair? Is that your plug for the week?
That's my plug, is John's hair. Yeah, so if you go to twitch.tv/John's hair, you can join our community. No, I don't know. We have cerulean skies at all times here, so if you want to play some games with your boys, we're doing a weekly RPG podcast now. We started yesterday. And then what else do we have? We're still doing our Ease event. Kelly is going to be doing Ease 5, I think, at some point soon. And then when she's done with Eastward and Eastward. Did I make that joke before? I think I did.
You probably did. It's an East joke. At some point, you've made it on this show, Joey. Mm-hmm.
All I know is that an Ease game, it ain't easy.
No!
Jesus. I love YS, all right?
Wise.
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 Yeah, right. Wise. Every time I do this show, I ask myself, Wise.
Wise, hey, Wise.
Hey,
wise guy.
All right.
And I guess one thing I haven't really plugged, but that we've been doing is we do Mega Man Mondays.
If you ever want to watch a stream at 3 o'clock in the morning of Joey playing some fucking Mega Man X, then there's one place to do it, and that's really in Sky's Bay B. Yeah. It's 4 a.m. and Yahiko is live, and that's why I love him.
And I'll segue this into Kelly because I kind of mentioned her. So Kelly, what about you? What you got?
Yeah, I have two chapters remaining of Eastward. I have high hopes and aspirations of knocking it all out in one long stream. Maybe this weekend. And then also I have the joy, pleasure, and honor of playing through East 5.
Eastward. Yeah. Hey. Eastward.
It's such a good game. It's so fun.
I've been really enjoying it.
What about you, Rachel?
Well, I mean, I've been saying that I'm going to stream like every weekend for the last like 3 weekends, and I just haven't because I've had so much to do. But I stream on Twitch too. It's under Outrageous. I'm sure someone can pop that.
Drop that bad boy
in the chat. I've been kind of playing, you know, Sea of Thieves, and I'm trying to work my way back through again all of the like kind of retro Harry Potter games.
I have been looking for an excuse to play Sea of Thieves for the first time, and I like survival crafting games. All right. So if you ever need an excellent, I will stay in pirate character the entire time. So
just say, my God,
my latest D&D character is a space hippo pirate man, gold tusk the greedy. So I'm all about it.
I love that. It's a good game. It's really fun, and it's more fun with friends. So I do appreciate having more people to play with, because it's kind of hard to like. I play it kind of weird times, and everyone's like, I'm doing something else right now. And I'm like, okay, bye. But yeah, I'm trying to work my way through all the retro Potter games as a countdown for Hogwarts Legacy.
Are you doing the like RPG, like handheld games, like the Game Boy Color? Those games are awesome.
I'm playing Sorcerer's Stone / Philosopher's Stone right now. It's one little RPG. Baby's first RPG.
Mm-hmm. One of my favorite little be like, oh, have you played the Harry Potter card game RPG? And they're like, what the fuck are you talking about, Frank? And I'm like, it's true. It's true. It's real.
Yep. But that's what I'm doing. Will I stream tomorrow night doing this? Maybe. Who knows? We'll see. It's a mystery. And if not, probably at some point this weekend. But yeah, that's what I've been doing.
Fan-fucking-tastic. On my note, you guys know me, I'm always doing the premium edition stuff. Super RPG Friends, that's my main lady. Show the support. If you're not in the Discord already, join that bad boy. If someone could type an exclamation point LT in the chat, it should work. We'll see. Maybe. It looks like the cloud bot's running. But, again, thank you everybody for coming out. Guests, viewers, lurkers, every single one of you. We're going to be shooting over to a good friend of the channel, Chet Manley. You guys have probably seen him in chat. He'll be back on the show sometime soon. But make sure when you guys head over there, let him know where you came from and be an awesome member of his chat. But at that note, I'd say it's probably just about time to close this show the way that we always do, starting with Earthbound, our first game. And that is with a very beautiful 3, 2, 1... Fuzzy Pickles, everybody. Fuzzy see you guys next week. Be sure to look out. Probably do an OSRS, Old School RuneScape stream on Sunday. We will see you guys soon. Have a great fucking night.